26,000 Australians are born too early each year, and this number has been progressively increasing, as it has for all developed countries. It had always been my career ambition to discover how we could safely lower the rate of preterm birth. No country has ever lowered its preterm birth rate. Then one night in 2013, together with a colleague, I was in the operating theatre of our hospital. We'd had a woman who'd come in preterm labour. She was 24 weeks pregnant. The waters had broken, the baby was lying sideways, and we'd had to do a very invasive cesarean section to safely deliver this baby. We handed the baby of 600 grams to the paediatricians, and I knew what lay ahead for the child and for the family. It was going to be months in the intensive care unit. Our paediatricians will do a wonderful job, but there's no getting away from the fact that this child would spend its first few months in plastic, breathing through plastic, and being fed through plastic. For the parents, the many months ahead can be very lonely and very frightening. Their child basically belongs to the hospital, and eventually when they're given the child to take home, they're full of fear as to what the future will hold. As we walked down the corridor, I said to our registrar, 6 weeks ago, this woman would have had her mid-pregnancy scan. So how can we possibly leave this unattended to? How can we possibly continue to let women go past 20 weeks of pregnancy without doing all we can to make sure they're not going to have a preterm birth? So in the corridor outside the operating theatre that night in 2013, I decided that we had enough information to roll out across the state of Western Australia a whole of state, whole of population program called the Whole 9 Months, making sure that no baby would be delivered before 39 weeks of pregnancy without an obstetric or medical reason, and that the mid-pregnancy scans throughout the state would all include measurement of the length of the cervix. Because we knew by this stage that at 19 weeks of pregnancy, the length of the cervix, measured by ultrasound, can predict when the birth will occur, and if it's shortened, we have a treatment that may prevent it from happening. In the first year, the rate of preterm birth fell by 8% across the state and by 20% in our major centre. As a team, and me as an individual, we were absolutely astounded the success of this program could be so rapid. But indeed it has been, and it appears to be sustained. We were then supported to roll the program out across the rest of Australia. And in June 2018, the Australian Preterm Birth Prevention Alliance was born. Australia is now the first nation on earth to have a national program aimed at lowering this major complication of pregnancy. There's no doubt that in the field of prevention of preterm birth, Australia is now a world leader. And there is no reason why we can't continue to expand this effect and that the rest of the world can follow.